Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he'd be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Got no parallel. Very different from the rest of us.
She's nothing like the rest of us. She's different from the rest of us. She's Belle.
I got it! I got it! Wow! You didn't miss a shot, Gaston! You must be the greatest hunter in the whole world!
I know.
No beast stands a chance against you! And no girl, for that matter.
It's true, LeFou. Yeah, I've got my sights set on that one.
The inventor's daughter?
She's the one. The lucky girl I'm going to marry.
But she...
The most beautiful girl in town.
I know,
that makes her the best. And don't I deserve the best?
Of course you do, but did...
Right from the moment when I met her, saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I fell. Here in town, there's only she who's beautiful as me. So I'm making plans to woo and marry Belle.
There he goes, isn't he dreamy? Monsieur Gaston, I suck it! Be still, my heart, I'm hardly breathing. He's such a tall, dark, strong, and handsome brute.
Good day.
Some cheese.
Excuse me.
I'll get the knife.
Please let me.
I don't understand.
Bonjour, Gaston. Excuse me. Gaston, may I have my book, please?
Can you read this? There's no pictures.
Well, some people use their imaginations.
Well, it's about time you get your head out of these books and paid attention to more important things.
Hint. Hint. You?
Exactly! The whole town's practically talking about it. It's not right for a woman to read. Soon she starts getting ideas and thinking.
Gaston, you are positively primeval.
Why, thank you, Belle. What do you say you and me head over to the tavern and take a look at my trophies?
What do you say we don't?
Oh, come on, Belle. I think I know how you feel about me.
You can't even imagine. Gaston, please, I have to get inside to help my father.
That crazy old kook. He needs all the help he can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yeah, don't talk about her father that way.
My father's not crazy. He's a genius.
Genius.
What's a genius?
Now, LeFou, I want you to go out into the woods and bring me back the biggest, healthiest deer you can find.
No, not the woods. Anything but the woods. You know I hate the woods.
Just get me a deer for my wedding feast.
But I hate the woods. It's dark, and it's spooky, and there's bugs. And spiders, and... Oh.
Papa, are you all right?
I'm fine, but I can't for the life of me figure out why that happened. If this isn't the stubbornest piece of... Ow!
Papa.
I'll never get this boneheaded contraption to work.
Yes, you will. And you'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow. And become a world-famous inventor.
You really think so?
You know I do. I always have.
Well, we better get cracking. Now, where did I put that dog-legged clencher?
Papa.
So tell me, did you have a good time in town today?
I got a new book.
You do love those books?
Well, they take me away to wonderful places where there's adventure and mystery and romance and happy endings. Papa, if I ask you something, will you answer me honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think I'm odd?
My daughter? Odd? Now, where would you get an idea like that?
I don't know. It's just that, well, people talk.
They talk about me, too. No, I'm not odd, nor you. No family ever saner, except one uncle who, well, maybe let that pass. In all you say and do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like them.
They are the common herd, and you can take my word. You are unique, creme de la creme. No matter what you do, I'm on your side. And if my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed, there's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot, no matter what.
No matter what they say, you make me proud. I love the funny way you stand out from the crowd.
It's my intention, my invention shows the world out there one day just what we've got. No matter what. Now some may say all fathers just exaggerate,
that every daughter's great.
You are.
And every daughter tends to say her father's tops.
She pulls out all the stops to praise him, and quite rightly. No matter what the pain, we've come this far. I pray that you remain exactly as you are. This really is a case of father knowing best,
and daughter too.
You're never strange.
Don't ever change.
You're all I've got, no matter what. Now what do you say we give her a try?
All right.
You get the logs. All right, stand back. Here we go.
It works.
It does? Oh, it does.
Papa, you did it. You really did it. You'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow. I know it.
Who knows? Maybe I will at that.
Oh, I almost forgot. Made you a scarf for good luck.
Oh, now I know I'll win. And when I do, we'll travel to all those places you've read about in your books. Well, I'm off.
Bye, Papa.
Bye-bye, Belle. Nearly mine. It's quite my best invention. So simple yet complex, so massive yet so small. This triumph of design will be my old age pension. That is, providing I can find the fare at all.
I must have missed the sign. I should have paid attention. That's not a nightingale. And not a mating call. Wolves!
And I need a place to stay for the night.
Oh, poor fellow. Cogsworth, have a heart. Monsieur, you are welcome here.
I heard that, and I'll thank you to step out to where I can see you.
Hello.
Ah!
Goodbye.
Oh, wait. Wait. You are clock, and you are talking?
Well, astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Now, goodbye.
Oh, this is amazing. How is this accomplished?
Now, really, sir, if you pay... Oh. Stop it!
Well, I'm stumped. This must be one of those newfangled scientific gadgets.
Well, I, sir, am not a gadget!
Oh, I beg your pardon. I don't mean to be rude. It's just I've never seen a tug.
A trap! Yes.
Oh, monsieur, you are chilled to the bone. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
Lumiere, we cannot have this stranger here. Not the monster's chance of seeing this.
Oh, la la, what have we here? Do my eyes deceive me, or is this a man? Oh, it's been so long since I've seen a real man. Oh. No offense, Lumiere. Bonjour, monsieur. Mind if I sit here?
Oh, hello.
Oh, this has gone far enough. I'm in charge here and...
Oh.
How would you like a spot of tea, sir? It will warm you up in no time.
Oh, yes, please.
No, no tea. He will be here all night. No tea.
There you are.
This is just what I need.
Ah! I think I scared him, Mama.
Hello there, little lady. What's your name?
Chip!
Oh, figures.
Careful, blanket, monsieur. I just love older men.
Babette! You are always trying to make me jealous. Well, it will not work this time.
Me? What about you, Simone?
Jacques.
Michel.
Pierre.
Véronique.
Véronique.
Lumiere, do you have any idea what the master will do if he finds out we let a stranger in?
Oh, relax, Cogsworth. The master will never have to know. As I was saying, he was bound to find out sooner or later.
Should we hide, Mama?
No, do not hide. There is absolutely no reason to panic.
Lumiere's right. There's absolutely no reason to panic. Excuse me.
There's a stranger here.
Master, allow me to explain. The gentleman, he was set upon by wolves.
Who let him in?
Master, please understand that I fought against it from the start.
Who dared to disobey me?
Oh, dear.
You have all betrayed me. Who are you?
Maurice.
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way.
You're not welcome here.
I'll just be on my way.
It's
hideous, isn't it?
Oh, no, I wasn't.
You've come to stare at the beast, haven't you?
No, I was merely looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay.
It's so. Ladies, ladies, I'm only getting married. Don't tell me a little thing like that's gonna change your feelings for me.
Oh, no.
No.
Never.
And we'll still have our rendezvous, won't we?
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Always.
Great. Well, if we're gonna have a wedding, I guess I'd better propose to the bride. Run along now. Belle. Oh, Belle. I know you're around here somewhere. Oh, hello.
Gaston? What a pleasant surprise.
Isn't it, though? I'm just full of surprises. Oh, for you, mademoiselle.
A miniature portrait of you. You shouldn't have.
Don't mention it. You know, Belle, there isn't a girl in town who wouldn't want to be in your shoes right now. Today is the day your dreams come true.
What could you possibly know about my dreams, Gaston?
Plenty. Been dreaming just one dream nearly all your life, hoping, scheming just one thing. Will you be a wife? Will you be some he-man's property? Good news, that he-man's me. This equation, girl plus man, doesn't help just you. On occasion, women can have their uses too, mainly to extend the family tree. Pumpkin, extend with me. We'll be raising sons galore.
Inconceivable.
Each built 6'4".
Unbelievable.
Each one stuffed with Eric Gaston G.
I'm not hearing
You'll
this.
Be keeping house with pride.
Just incredible.
Each day gratified.
So unwettable.
That you are part of this idyllic scene. Picture this. A rustic hunting lodge. My latest kill roasting over the fire. My little wife massaging my feet. While the little ones play on the floor with the dogs. We will have them. 6 or 7.
Dogs?
No, Belle. Strapping boys like me.
Imagine that.
I can see that we will share all that love implies. We shall be the perfect pair, rather like my thighs. You are face to face with destiny. All roads lead to the best things in life are all's well. There's no way certain as to a Belle when you marry. So, Belle, what'll it be? Is it yes, or is it, oh, yes?
I just don't deserve you.
Who does?
Me! But thanks for asking.
You know that Belle. Always playing hard to get.
She turned you down?
For now. But I will have Belle for my wife. Make no mistake about that.
Well, gee, if she turned him down,
Maybe I still have a chance.
Oh my god, Aaron!
No way!
Is he gone? Can you imagine? He asked me to marry him. Me, the wife of that boorish, brainless Madame Gaston. Can't you just see it? Madame Gaston, his little wife. No, sir, not me. I guarantee it. I want much more than this provincial life. I want adventure in the great wide somewhere. I want it more than I can. Someone understand. I want so much more than they've got planned.
Belle! Have you seen Gaston anywhere?
You just missed him. Wait! Where did you get this?
Oh, this? I found it in the woods. Pretty nice, huh?
This belongs to my father!
Yeah, well, finders keepers!
LeFou? I want you to think hard and tell me exactly where you found it.
No!
Think!
In the woods!
Harder!
Somewhere near the crossroads, okay? Ow!
Then he's still out there somewhere. LeFou, you have to take me back!
Not the woods again!
Don't you see? Something must have happened! You have to take me back!
Not on your life!
Then I'll find him myself!
Keep quiet, could we? Just had to invite him to stay, didn't we? Serve him tea, sit in the master's chair.
I was trying to be hospitable.
Oh, rubbish!
Cogsworth, can you blame me for trying to maintain what is left of our humanity? Look at us. Look at you.
What about me?
Well, you always were a little insufferable, but every day you become just a little more inflexible, a little more tightly wound, a little more ticked off.
Please spare me the stupid puns.
Oh, but at least we are not far gone as some of the others. You saw what happened to Michelle.
Well, she was always too vain about her looks, and that's exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
It'll draws mirrors the works.
And Jean-Claude. Jean-Claude, you remember him? Not too bright, dumb as
a brick.
The whole wall.
Jean-Claude's a brick wall.
That's him in the kitchen behind the stove.
Tick-tock!
And you know Guillaume, the houseboy?
Well, that mealy-mouthed little bootlicker. I never liked him. He was always groveling at the master's feet.
He's a doormat.
Perfect!
It might be happening faster with some of the others, but we are not far behind. Slowly but surely, as every day passes, we will all gradually become things.
Okay, well, I don't understand how we got dragged into this spell business in the first place. It's not like we threw that poor old beggar woman out on her ear.
No, but are we not responsible for helping make him the way he is?
I suppose so.
All I know is I will eventually melt away into nothing. I only hope there is something left of me if the master ever breaks the spell.
We've got to hold on, old man. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anybody here? Hello?
Oh, it's a girl!
Yes, I can see it's a girl!
It's a girl, mademoiselle!
Lumiere, let me do all the talking!
Yoo-hoo.
Lumiere, head of this household, I demand to do all the talking!
Jerry!
A word, just a word! That's all I'm asking for!
Mama, you're not going to believe what I saw. Not in a million years. Not in a trillion years. Not in a million, trillion, thousand years.
Yes, dear.
No, really, it's the best thing. It's the thing we've all been waiting for since... Well, I don't know when.
All right, Chip, what is it?
There's a girl in the castle.
Bless my soul, wouldn't that be lovely?
But there is. I saw her.
Now, Chip, I'll not have you making up wild stories, getting everyone's hopes up for no reason.
Mrs. Potts, did you hear? There's a girl in the castle.
See, I told ya. And she's really pretty, too.
Well, I don't know about that.
Oh, this is it! The one we have been waiting for, the girl we have been waiting for, she has come to break this spell!
Wait a minute, let's not be hasty!
Oh, after all these years, oh, happy, happy day! Oh.
Stop it! Stop that!
We should tell the others, no?
Wait a minute!
Hello? Is anyone here? Please, I'm looking for my father.
Belle, is that you?
Papa!
How did you find me here?
Your hands are like ice. We have to get you out of here.
Belle, you must leave this place.
Who's done this to you?
There's no time to explain. You must go now.
I won't leave you. Who's there? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Then you're the one who's responsible for this. Release my father at once!
I am the master of this castle! I do not take orders from anyone! Throw her out!
No, wait! Please, forgive me. Please, let him out! Can't you see he's not well?
Then he should not have trespassed here.
But he's an old man! He could die!
He came into my home uninvited, and now he'll suffer the consequences.
Please, I'll do anything!
There's nothing you can do!
Wait, please!
I said there's nothing you can do!
Take me instead!
No! What did you say?
Take me instead.
Belle, you don't know what you're doing!
You would do that? You would take his place?
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes. But you must promise to stay here. Forever.
No!
Forever?
Forever! Or he dies in the dungeon.
That's not fair! Wait. Come closer.
Make your choice.
Belle, listen to me. I'm old. I've lived my life.
You have my word.
Done.
No.
Papa.
No. What are you doing?
Take him to the crossroads.
Wait. No, not yet.
Let go of me. Belle!
Master, please, since the girl is going to be staying with us for quite some time, we might want to offer her a more comfortable room.
You didn't let me say goodbye.
What?
I'll never see him again, and I didn't even get to say goodbye.
I'll show you to your room.
My room? But I thought...
You want to stay here in the dungeon?
No.
Then follow... You follow me! This is your home now. You're free to go wherever you like. Except the West Wing.
Why? What's in the-
It's forbidden! You are never to set foot there! Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes!
This is your room. I hope you'll be comfortable here. If you need anything, my servants will attend you. And one more thing. You will join me for dinner. That is not a request!
Yes, I made the choice. For Papa, I will stay. But I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way, you monster. If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool.
should learn to be happy. Never dreamed that a home could be dark and cold. I was told every day in my childhood, even when we grow old, home should be where the heart is. Never were words so true. My heart's far, far away, home is too. What I give to return to the life that I knew lately, and to think I complained of that dull provincial.
Was it?
Mrs. Potts, dear. I thought you might like some tea.
Come in.
Nothing like a nice, warm cup of tea to make the world seem a bit brighter.
But you're...
Mrs. Potts, dear. Very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Careful, darling.
Who are you?
Monsieur de la Grande Bouche. Perhaps you've heard of me?
Sorry.
You see? They've forgotten all about me. One can be the toast of Europe, the brightest star to ever grace the stage, but fall under one little spell.
Shh. Wait. This is impossible.
I know it is, but here we are. Now, what shall we dress you in for dinner? This is nice, but how would you like to borrow one of my capes? Let's see what I've got in my drawers. Ah, here we are. I wore this the night I performed at the Royal Opera. The king himself was there, of course. I wouldn't have a prayer of fitting into it now, so take it.
That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
Don't be silly, of course you are. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine! I'm sorry. Things are just happening so fast.
That was a very brave thing you did, my dear.
We all think so.
I'm going to miss my papa so much.
Cheer up, child. I know things may seem bleak right now, but you mustn't despair. We're here to see you through. I hope that we'll be friends. I don't know you well. If anyone can make the most of living here, then Belle, it's you. And who knows? You may find home here too.
does she think she is? That girl's tangled with the wrong man.
Darn right.
No one says no to Gaston. Dismissed, rejected, publicly humiliated. It's more than I can bear.
More beer?
And what for? Nothing helps. I'm disgraced.
Who? You? Never. Gaston, you've got to pull yourself together. Gosh, it disturbs me to see you, Gaston, looking so down in the dumps. Every guy here loved to be you, Gaston, even when taking your lumps. There's no man alive as admired as you. You're everyone's favorite guy. Everyone's awed and inspired by you. Quick as Gaston, no one's next as incredibly thick as Gaston, for there's no man in town half as manly. Perfect, a pure paragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they prefer to be on. No one's big like Gaston,
a kingpin like Gaston.
No one's got a small cleft in his chin like Gaston.
As a specimen, yes, I'm intimidating.
My what a guy that Gaston! Give 5 hurrahs, give 12 hip hips.
Gaston is the best and the rest is all tricks.
No one
fights like Gaston, that fights like Gaston.
In a wrestling match, nobody fights like Gaston.
When there's no one as burly and brawny.
As you see, I've got biceps to spare.
Not a bit of him scraggly or scrawny.
That's right. And every last inch of me's covered in hair.
No one hits like Gaston. Matches wits like Gaston.
In a spitting match, nobody spits like Gaston.
I'm especially good at expectorating.
10 points for Gaston.
When I was a lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every morning to help me get large. And now that I'm grown, I eat 5 dozen eggs, so I'm roughly the size of a bird.
No one shoots like Gaston, makes those dudes like Gaston.
No tromping around wearing coats like Gaston.
I use antlers in all.
Will you help me? Can you help me, someone, please? Oh, please, you gotta help me. He's got her. He's got her locked in a dungeon.
Oh,
Belle.
Whoa, slow down, Maurice. Who has Belle locked in a dungeon?
A beast! A horrible, monstrous beast!
Is it a big beast?
Huge!
With spooky yellow eyes?
Yes, yes!
And a big ugly snout?
Hideously ugly!
And cruel sharp fangs!
Yes, yes! Will you help me? Will you help me?
Alright, old man. We'll help you out.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Alright! I guess I'll go out there and get her myself!
Crazy old Maurice.
Always good for a laugh.
Crazy old Maurice. Crazy old Maurice. The fool I'm afraid I've been thinking.
A dangerous pastime?
I know. But that crazy old coot is Belle's father, and his sanity's only so-so. Now the wheels in my head have been turning since I first saw that crazy old man. See, I promised myself I'd be married to Belle, and right now I'm evolving a plan. If I...
Yes?
Then we...
No, would she?
Yes!
I get it!
Let's go!
No!
take cheap shots like Gaston.
Lancer, persecute, harmless, crackpots like Gaston.
Yes, I'm endlessly wildly resourceful.
As down to the depths you descend.
I won't even be mildly remorseful.
Just as long as you get what you want in the end.
Who has brains like Gaston?
Entertained like Gaston.
Who can make up these endless refrains like Gaston? So his marriage we soon will be celebrating. My, what a guy, Gaston!
Well, what is it?
Oh, is dinner ready, Mrs. Pop?
Just about. I haven't the foggiest idea what she likes to eat, so I've cooked up everything in the kitchen.
Good, good. Well, don't just stand there gaping. Get back to work.
You tell her.
I can't.
Tell me what?
Now, don't be alarmed. But there is something on your back.
Well, what on earth are you talking about? Oh, what is that?
It appears to be a winding handle of some sort.
Okay, well, get it off me.
Oh, it won't come off.
It won't come off.
What do you mean it won't come off? It wasn't there last night when I went to bed. What is this? Why is this happening to me?
It's the spell, I'm afraid.
Just try to relax.
Relax? Relax? How could I relax with this appendage on my back? Is there no dignity left within me? And what's to go next? My mind?
Calm down. It will be all right.
I am frightened, Lumiere.
I know, my friend, but you are not alone.
We're all in this together.
It's time for dinner. Where is she?
Oh, perhaps I should go see about her. Won't be a minute.
I told her to come down. What's taking so long?
Try to be patient, sir. The girl has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Master, have you thought that perhaps this girl could be the one to break the spell?
Of course I have.
Good. So you fall in love with her, she falls in love with you, and poof, the spell is broken. We'll be human again by midnight.
Lumiere, it's not that easy. These things take time.
But we don't have the time. The rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She's so beautiful, and I'm... Well, look at me.
He has a point. Shh.
Master, you must help her to see past all that.
I don't know how.
Well, you could start by trying to make yourself more... presentable. Straighten up. Try to act like a gentleman.
Impress her with your rapier wit.
But be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere.
And above all...
What?
You must control your temper.
Well?
What?
Where is she?
Oh!
Circumstances being what they are. She's not coming.
What did you say?
She's not coming.
We'll see about that.
Your lordship, your grace, your eminence. Let's not be hasty.
Stay where you are. Lumiere, stand aside. I thought I told you to come down to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I am the master of this castle, and I am telling you to come to dinner.
And I'm telling you, I'm not hungry.
Oh, you're hungry if I say you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous.
What did you say?
You can't go around ordering people to be hungry. It doesn't work like that.
I can
Besides, it's rude.
Oh, rude, is it? Then how about this? If you don't come down to dinner, I will drag you by the hair.
Master, that might not be the best way to win the girl's affection.
Yes, please, attempt to be a gentleman.
But Why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come down to dinner.
So, you admit you're being a bully.
Deep breaths, Master, deep breaths.
I'll give her one last chance. Would you be so kind as to join me for dinner? Please!
No, thank you.
Fine! Then starve!
Oh, Monsieur, Monsieur, please!
She doesn't eat with me! She doesn't eat at all!
Oh, what were we thinking? We will never be human again.
I suppose you're right. Well, what would you two have us do? Just give up? I can't give up until I hear the sound of my daughter's laughter as she runs through these halls again.
Mrs. Potts is right. We mustn't give up while there's still a chance. Lumiere, stand guard at the door, and if there's any change, notify me at once.
Oui, mon capitaine.
I ask nicely and she refuses. What does she want me to do? Beg? Show me the girl.
I know the master can be temperamental, but underneath all that matted fur, he's not such a bad fellow. Why don't you give him a chance?
Why should I? Did he give my father a chance?
Well, no, but once you get to know him...
I don't want to get to know him. I don't want to have anything to do with him.
I'm just fooling myself. She'll never see me as anything but a monster. How long must this go on, this cruel trick of fate? I simply made one careless wrong decision, and then that witch was gone and left me in this state, an object of revulsion and derision, hated. Is there no one who can show me how to win the world's forgiveness? No! What did they say? Shower her with compliments. Impress her with your wit. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman.
Let me in! Let me in!
Ah, Bet! Oh, come to me, my little fluff.
Oh, it's my aunt, isn't it? You do not love me anymore. Oh, this horrible, horrible smell.
Oh, chérie, you cut me to the wick. Did you really think a little thing like that would change my feelings for you? Now you really tickle my fancy.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no, no, no. I've been bent by you before.
Oh.
Actually, monsieur, I am a little hungry.
I'll ring for Mrs. Potts. I'll sing you an aria as we wait.
That's all right. I'll go myself.
The master won't like that.
I know.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
I like this girl. I like her spunk.
Well, if you ask me, she was just being stubborn. After all, he did say please.
I do believe that's the first time I've ever heard him use that word.
And I believe you're right.
But you see, she's already starting to have a good influence on him. There you are, dearie. Glad to see you out and about.
I am Cogsworth. Head of the household.
Cogsworth, the girl, she is gone. I swear my eyes never left the... Oh, gentil, mademoiselle.
Mrs. Lumiere. Okay, stop. Stop that. If there's anything we could do for you, anything at all, please let me know.
I am a little hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth.
Well, You heard what the master said. We cannot feed her.
Oh, pish posh. I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
I'm in. A glass of water. Crust of bread.
Cogsworth, I am surprised at you. She is not a prisoner, no. She's our guest, and we must make her feel welcome here.
Fine then, dinner. But we cannot be loud. If the master hears us, it'll be our necks.
Of course, but what is dinner without a little music?
Music?
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you here tonight. And now, we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest, be our guest. At our service, to the test. Tie your napkin round your neck, Sherry, and we'll provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot or tough, why we only live to serve. Try the great stuff.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me? Ask the dishes, they can say. And then you'll be our guest. We our guest, be our guest.
Deep fried goo, cheese souffle, pie and pudding on a plate.
We prepare and serve with flair on culinary cabaret. You're alone and you're scary, but deep in with our preparing. No one's gloomy or complaining while the flatware's entertaining.
We tell jokes,
I do tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
And it's all in perfect taste that you can bet. Come on and lift your glass. You've won your own free pass to be our guest.
If you're stressed, eat fine dining, we suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
Are gone. 10 years we've been arrested. s'mores and dusting, eating exercise, or tongues to use our skin.
Most is we just lay around the castle.
Flabby, fat, and Lizzie, you are Dylan, oopsie daisy. Babette!
Come to me, my little sister.
Mia, this has gone too far! This is shameless! Shameless!
You look ridiculous!
Dinner. It was delicious.
It was my pleasure, mademoiselle.
Well, look at the time. Off to bed.
Oh, I couldn't possibly go to bed now. It's my first time in an enchanted castle.
Enchanted? Who said anything about this castle being enchanted? It was you, wasn't it?
Oh.
I figured it out for myself. I'd like to look around, if that's all right.
Oh, perhaps you would like a tour.
Okay, well, come here. I don't think that's such a good idea. You wouldn't want a you-know-who go looking around you-know-where, if you know what I mean.
Perhaps you'd like to take me. I'm sure you know all there is to know about the castle.
Well, actually, I do. Now, if you will take a look at the handcrafted ceilings, complete with cherubs frolicking amidst the nymphs and centaurs, come.
Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. This will be good. Oh, Belle. Belle?
Now, if you will note the unusual inverted archways, this is yet another example of the neoclassic Baroque period. And as I always say, if it's not Baroque, don't fix it. Anyway, may I draw your attention to the flying buttresses above the aviary?
Oh, Lumiere, it's all so beautiful. I had no idea. If only he weren't here.
Act like a gentleman. I am nothing but a fool.
Ah, And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted. And that was the last time the stone of that weight was quarried in the area.
What's over there?
Nothing. There's nothing at all of any interest in the West Wing.
Ah, so that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
I wonder what he's hiding over there.
There's no hiding in this castle.
Then it wouldn't be forbidden, would it?
Okay, well, perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else. We have tapestries dating all the way back to Aloysius the Pretentious.
Maybe later.
Oh, maybe you would like to see the gardens. No. Or the library.
You have a library?
With books.
Mountains of books. Scads of books, cloudbursts of books, cascades of books, swarms of books.
Books with pictures, books with words.
More words than you could read in a lifetime.
Books on every subject by every author who ever sent pen to papier. Come, come. That.
I'm sorry.
What are you doing here?
I
told you never to come here.
I know, but
you have no right to be here. Get out.
Don't touch me.
No, I'm sorry. I
promise or no promise, I won't stay here.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you. I didn't mean to frighten you. You don't understand. There's so little left of me. So little left.
Twisted face, there's not the slightest trace of anything that even hints at kindness. And from my tortured shame, no comfort, no escape. I see, but deep within is utter blindness, hopeless, as my dream dies, as the time flies. Love, a lost illusion, helpless, unforgiven, cold and driven to this sad conclusion. No beauty could move me, no goodness improve me, no power on earth if I can't love her. No passion could teach me how I could have loved her and make her love me too if I can't love her. Then who? Long ago I should have seen all the things I could have been. Careless and unthinking, I moved onward. Be deep. could be cheaper. No point anymore if I can't love her. No spirit could win me, no hope left within me. Hope I could have loved her and that she'd set me free. But it's not to be if I can't love her. Let the world be.